It's 500 rupees.
Give it to me for 100 rupees.
No. I started to walk. A loud voice interrupts my footsteps. 150 rupees, final price. This was the scenario where I was negotiating with the vendor at Palika Bazaar in Delhi. Such an amazing strategy. The vendor calls me from behind. It is called direct marketing, where the modus operandi is very clear. Business, by hook or by crook. We see many situations in our life where we have to learn the art of negotiation. And now, through this process, when we have learned the art of negotiation and we actually saved 350 rupees, let us now search for an accommodation. Another revolutionary strategy. Nowadays, people buy a flat in an apartment, provide some facilities like fridge, TV, washing machine, and they proudly mention about parking. Absolutely free. As if you won't get the parking if you rent the apartment otherwise. These kind of situations happen. Two people per room, paying 6,000 per person. The total rent of the apartment might be around 20,000 rupees. But he is getting 36,000 rupees. Flat 16,000 rupees profit in a month. And approximately 2.5 lakh rupees profit in a year. Amazing strategy. Now, you got the accommodation, but what about the basic needs? That's where the dot-com sites come into picture. Bigbasket.com, Flipkart.com, eBay.com. With only the usage of the greatest invention, cell phone, they are making huge profits. They deliver the goods at a doorstep if the price is above a certain limit, and thereby adjusting the transportation cost. The quality of the goods is not compromised. And the delivery boy delivers the products with a smile. Smile, the only curve which sets everything straight and gets you money in return. Well, we have got an accommodation. Our daily needs are catered to. But where is liquidity? Expenditure. There are plenty of options. One famous example is the temple business, which will never ever die. Let me give you a personal example. When I had gone to my hometown, we had Sai Baba idol in a palanquin that we were bringing from temple to our home. On the way, whoever saw that palanquin came to it with 100 rupees, 50 rupees, or some denomination. At the end of the day, I calculated the collections. 25,000 rupees. I looked at the Sai Baba idol and then at the collections and wondered, how would Sai Baba utilize this much amount of money? But it has to go somewhere. Unfortunately, not in my pockets. You did not lose much money in it, right? Only 100 rupees? Don't worry. Let me introduce you to a businessman who will help you lighten your wallets. Any guesses? Doctors. How? Let me share an example. Few months ago, I visited a doctor because I was down with fever. While he was examining me, I asked him a question. Why did I fall ill? Doctors say an apple a day keeps a doctor away. I also eat an apple a day. Then why did I fall ill? He looked at me and responded, oh, that's a myth. You come to me, don't waste your money on apples. Even the doctors are doing business. They don't have any other goal. Even they have their priorities. They are promoting themselves. Everybody, from doctors to engineers, from CEO to employees, and from judges to lawyers is doing some or the other business, using some or the other innovative distinguished strategy or something that is already in fashion. We can also utilize these ideas. Then why don't we do it? At least I am planning to start my own business. And my modus operandi is very crystalline. I will start charging my future speeches. That's how it works. That's a business. You have to learn these new arts. All these innovative ideas reminds me of one very famous quote. A business has to be involving. It has to be fun. And it has to exercise your creative instincts. Fellow Toastmasters, don't stay in bed unless you can make money in bed. Don't procrastinate. Start a business. Do business today, enjoy tomorrow. Over to you, Toastmasters.